So fisa nje ukuthinta izinto ezimbili noma ezintathu amavoti omkhonto wesizwe antshontshiwe noma isystem yaka IC eyarigwa iyenze ukuthi abantu base South Africa noma abantu bakwaZulu Natal be deprive iright yabo yokulidwa uhulumeni womkhonto. Umkhonto wesizwe uthathile nge 2/3 majority. Umkhonto wesizwe kufanele ngabuphethe. Umkhonto wesizwe ke kulento esiyilwela namhlanje ingoba ubuzoqala ngabomthetho. Amaphoyisa eSouth Africa agcina ukunyuselwa imali noma ama public servants, your police, your nurse, your teachers. Agcina ukunyuselwa ngesikhathi sikancamalala ukunyuka kwangempela kwezinto. Yingakho siwumkhonto wesizwe sisho njalo. Okunye okumele sikusho namhlanje ukuthi le GNU ekhona manje ithema ingena nje izoyikhatha phansi into ye free education, izoyikhatha phansi into ka NSFAS. Asikwazi ke njengabantu abasha e South Africa sihlale ngathi akwenzekanga lutho. Uhulumeni ka Jacob Zuma ese office wa ensure ukuthi kuwo wonke ama projects akhona in our country through u public works kuzoba no 30% ozoyokhulisa abantu osoba business abancane. Uhulumeni we DA uthe mawungena ukhansela BEE ukhansela konke. Kufanele sazi ukuthi uma sihlangene kanje sithi siyalwa asimi ngoba sidlala. Laba abaphula umthetho kumele bajeze. Ujaji uZondo, ujaji uPoyo eprovincial legislature kumele be account for what has happened. As abantu abasha bomkhonto wesizwe, we are very clear. These elections were rigged. We don't want a recount. We don't want a recount because ballots were all over the place. People are calling for a recount. Where are we going to get those ballot papers? Because they were all disposed, they were all destroyed because bafuna ukulala evidence. The only thing we are calling for is the IEC to call the elections in 90 days to come back and vote for umkhonto wesizwe.
Siyavinjelwa nala sihamba khona. We know as umkhonto wesizwe ukuthi even the people of business who want to assist and support our programs are barred by ongqiwankulu because amandla asahleli kubona ongqiwankulu laba abaphethe labantu abathi baphethe abangaphansi kwe-GNU ephethwe uHelen Zille. Phansi noHelen Zille phansi. Phansi noHelen Zille phansi. Phansi neStellenbosch. Siyazi ukuthi ma commanders and commissars ground forces of umkhonto wesizwe ukuthi namhlanje nakukhona isela enalibambo qotsheni elizovela la enkantolo lintshontsha amavoti enu. Manje siyazibuza ukuthi bakwazi kanjani ka IEC provincially and nationally ukuthi ukhetho was free and fair. But namhlanje khona umuntu osazovela enkantolo zezomthetho. So comrades and comrades from the media, ngisacela ukuthi ningivumele egameni lenu ngifundele incwadi yeyikhalazo esithatha sibhekisa kuDeputy Chief Justice wase South Africa. Angeke sikwazi ukuyisa kuChief Justice wase South Africa uzondo because we believe ukuthi in cahoots ne Stellenbosch Mafia. So he cannot
decide
over our legal matters because now we are complice. So lencwadi i-memorandum sizoyidlulisa iqonde ku-Deputy Chief Justice uMaya. Deputy Chief Justice Maya, carbon copy, Chief Justice Zondo. By carbon copy, Judge President Poyojwati. Memorandum, court case pertaining IEC legal proceedings Umkungundlovu District or Moses Mabhida Region. The Judge President is the head of judiciary in KZN and she has a duty to establish a court that will deal with cases arising from the elections. The progress of these matters are reported to her and are listed as the matters that were pending before Parliament proceedings. First, is Blessislayer Police Station case 766/5 of 2024. The suspect was caught red-handed and with evidence. Secondly, Alexander case 25. It contains illegal disposal of ballot papers and boxes. A number of presiding officers were dismissed by IEC for corruption on the date of election. KZN IEC confirmed voting irregularities. The casting of votes is followed by counting thereof, and during this time, any party taking part in elections can make any objections. In the current elections, there were objections that were made and criminal cases that were opened. Despite that, the IEC went ahead and announced the result and wrongly declared that the elections were free and fair. We are demanding that the Deputy Chief Justice must uphold an action, the following remedial actions. Emanating from above mentioned, we demand the following. Lifestyle audit of all IEC officials. We believe and we are believing the allegations that seek to say some of the IEC personnel were bribed. And there are allegations that 5 million each were given to some of the personnel here in Moses Mabhida. Hence we call on the Deputy Chief Justice to instruct the composition and the conduct of live audit to all those IEC officials. We are also calling on the Deputy Chief Justice to probe Dr. Nomusa Masuku, who was a commissioner or which is a commissioner of the IEC, about the processes that were followed and due diligences that were followed and vetting before she was employed by the IEC. We believe that Dr. Masuku or Commissioner Masuku has close proximity to Mr. Cyril Ramaphosa. And we are of a view and belief that Cyril Ramaphosa colluded or suggested or recommended that Dr. Masuku must be hired by the IEC in order to facilitate the rigging of these elections. We are calling on the Deputy Chief Justice also to instruct the probing of Umsunduzi municipality, because their implements, their vehicles were the ones who were helping, you know, helping the IEC people to dispose of our votes. We want to know who was the driver of the truck, who authorized the driver of the truck, who was the manager behind, who was the IEC personnel who was in cahoots with the people of Umsunduzi. We are calling on the Deputy Chief Justice to conduct an investigation by the Judiciary Commission on Judge President Boyodlwa. We are handing it to the representative of the Department of Justice, for which we believe that it will reach the Deputy Chief Justice.